हाय देयर, दिस इज अजय जुड़गी। टुडे वी शैल सी यूआर्ट कम्युनिकेशन और हाउ टू इंटरफेस और हाउ टू इम्प्लीमेंट अ यूआर्ट प्रोटोकॉल और यूआर्ट कम्युनिकेशन ऑन अ पीकेटी ने 452। ओके, सो व्हाई वी नीड अ यूआर्ट कम्युनिकेशन और व्हाई वी शुड बी क्लियर विथ अ यूआर्ट कम्युनिकेशन। यूआर्ट इज नथिंग बट यूनिवर्सल असिंक्रोनस रिसीवर ट्रांसमीटर। Microcontroller uses this UART communication to communicate with the external world. For example, if you need to interface GSM modem, GPS receiver, Bluetooth, ZigBee, Wi-Fi, RFID, PC or anything with a microcontroller, then you need to be clear with the UART communication. It uses basically three lines: transmitter, receiver and ground. Okay. So data format for the UART communication is, it may have a start bit and it may have a one or two stop bits. And in between start and stop bits, there will be a 8 or 7 bit data. Okay, this is nothing but a ASCII value of a data to be transmitted. Okay, normally start bit is low and a stop bit is high. Okay, and in between the start bit and stop bit, we may have 7 or 8 data bits that may be ASCII value. Okay, so as I said, it may use 7 or 8 data bits, one start bit and one or two stop bits. Again, we have to worry about one more aspect, that is a baud rate. Okay, here we may select a baud rate according to our requirement, but here we shall go with the 9600. Okay, there is no compulsion that you should go with the 9600, but it's a convention and many devices have the by default baud rate as a 9600. There is no any other reason. Okay, now how to calculate the baud rate in case of PIC18F452 microcontroller. Okay, that we shall see little later. Okay, now the different registers that are associated with UART communication is SPBRG. Okay, serial port baud rate generation register. Okay, it will be having a value, say X. Okay, this number X will be deciding the baud rate of your serial communication. Okay, now how we have to decide the value of the X? Now we have the formula: baud rate is equal to the oscillation frequency crystal oscillator divided by 64 into X plus 1. Okay, now assume the crystal to be 10 megahertz and the baud rate is equal to 9600. Okay, now if you rearrange this, X will be equal to this number and finally X comes to be equal to 15. If I load X equal to 15 into SPBRG, that will set my baud rate equal to 9600. Okay, or if you change the baud rate, then you will have different value and your communication will have the different baud rate. The second register that is associated with a serial communication is TXSTR, transmit status and control register. Okay, here you can see the details of this register. Okay, and here we are interested in transmitter enable, this pin, and BRGH. Okay, now if you make the BRGH equal to low, that means the UART communication will be having the lower baud rate with the same crystal frequency, and if you set this one, you can have a higher baud rate with the same crystal frequency. So you should set, we have set this 0 and transmitter is enabled, TX enable. Okay, we are going to deal with these two pins in a TX STA register. Rest you can understand for your knowledge. Next register that is associated with UART communication is RC STA, receive status and control register. Here SPEN, we have to make this high. This is a serial port enable. Okay, and then we have to make this CREN equal to 1 because this is a continuous reception enable. Okay, then rest you can understand for your knowledge. Okay, for a time being it is not important for us, at least in this application. Okay, next we have RC reg. This is receive buffer. Whatever data is being received from the external world through the UART communication, that is stored in a RC reg register. Now if you need to transmit some data, then you have to put the ASCII value of data to be transmitted out of a microcontroller into a TX reg, that is a transmit buffer. One more register that is important is PIR1, okay, peripheral interrupt request flag register 1. Okay, here we should be worried about the RCIF, a reception flag, okay, or this is the receive IF interrupt flag upon the reception of a serial data. Okay, if microcontroller receives some data from external world through a UART communication, then RCIF will be high. Okay, once you read that data, that will be cleared. Okay, and suppose if you need to send some data from microcontroller to external world, you have to load the data into the TX reg, and upon sending the data successfully out of the microcontroller, the TXIF flag will be set. Okay, you can read for more information, you can read the content also. The next we can see the programming steps, that is step 1, you enable the SPN and serial continuous reception enable, load the SPBRG register with a count 15 for the baud rate 9600. You can load with the other values if you need the other, if you want to go with the other baud rate. Enable the transmitter, wait for serial data to receive. And in our program, what we did, if I receive 1, we are sending 2 by adding 1 to it. If I receive alphabet A, then it will be sending B. That means wait for serial data. If I give the input as A, it will send the data B. Okay, this is only for the understanding. Okay. Now next we shall go for the simulation. Okay, this is by simulation. If I say, as I said, if I give the say number 1, it should respond me with 2. If I press say 1, it is responding me with 2. I shall give the input 2 from the keyboard, it should give me the response as a 3. Now I give the input as a 3, it should give me 4. That means it is receiving a character, it is adding 1 to it, and it is sending back to me. Okay, now if I press say A, I'll give the input from keyboard is A, now it is giving me B. If I give say S, it will give me the output as a T. Okay, so this is only for the understanding. Now we shall see the actual code. That is absolutely simple. Okay, we are going with the crystal frequency 10 megahertz, RC STA equal to 90, that means what? 90H, that means RC STA equal to 9 means SPEN will be enabled and CREN will be enabled, as I said. Okay, then SPBRG equal to 15 for baud rate 9600, transmitter enabled, receiver serial port enabled, while 1 will put my code in infinite loop. I am waiting here for RCIF to go high. Okay, this RCIF will be 1 when I receive the data serially. Okay, so this will wait here as long as it does not receive a serial data. Once it receives the data, RCIF will be high. Okay, and that data is being saved in RC reg, receiver buffer register. Okay, I'm adding 1 to it and I'm sending that to the transmit register. Okay, TX reg buffer. Now again here, if I want to transmit, I have to monitor the flag TXIF. Okay, this will transmit the data whatever it has in a TX register. Okay, once it successfully transmits the content of TX reg, then this TXIF will be set. Okay, and then it can go for the next cycle. This is all about the serial communication or UART communication. Thank you.